Welcome. In this tutorial video, I want to show you how to use V-carving, how to create toolpath for V-carving using the DeskProto CAM software. It's the first tutorial video for the new DeskProto version 8 that just has been released, and I'm very happy that I now can present this great new feature to you, V-carving, which is, I will show you how you can create a very nice sign with only a very short toolpath. Well, for V-carving, you need a V-shaped cutter. Here I have a few. You can see the V-shaped tip of the cutter. It's also called V-bit. And its most important characteristic is the angle of the V. And that can, you have to take care, that can be defined in two ways. You can define the side angle of the V, or you can note the included angle of the V, which is exactly twice as large. So take care to use the correct number for your cutter definition. Okay, first I want to show you what V-carving exactly does, what it is. And in order to do so, I'll quickly open DeskProto. And in DeskProto, open the help file, as there I can find a few images that I can use to clearly demonstrate how V-carving works. Here we have DeskProto. Let me open the help file. Here we are in the index. I can look for V-carving. Carving, yes. Double click and double click here as well. This is the page about V carving, and this is the image that I wanted to show you. It shows the V-shaped cutter, the V bit, in a bit of a simplified drawing, but it shows what I need to show to you. Here is the deeper the cut goes, a shallow cut, a deep cut, the deeper the cut goes, the wider the resulting groove is. Well, that's an effect that we can use when we have a drawing like this, a 2D drawing. Then in order to exactly machine a groove of this width, we need to adapt the depth of the cut. And this toolpath then will result in this image on the top of the material. Here you see it. You can even create sharp inner corners. You see here this sloping upward toolpath. Here again, two sloping upward toolpath to the top of the material, and they will result in a sharp inner corner. Well, that is the basics of V-carving, and now we can start with our V-carving project. So in order to create a V-carving, I need to create a vector drawing, a vector drawing file that DeskProto can import and use as CAD data. Okay, for this tutorial, I want to use a simple wooden sign showing the name William in a nice font. And in order to create the vector drawing file, I want to use the Inkscape program, which is a completely free program for creating vector graphics. Note, this is not an Inkscape tutorial. I only briefly show the steps that are needed to create the file that I need. So I will start Inkscape. Here we are. I'll enter, start a new document in Inkscape. This is the Inkscape user interface with a sheet of paper that we can write on. And in order to write on that, I only want to use text in this project. So I use the text tool, and I need to select a font. Well, it has already been selected, Times New Roman, that's okay. And I need to select a font size. I found that 144 results in a text of about 36 millimeters high. That's okay. So I select the starting point and I enter my text, William. Here we are. This is the thing that I want to machine. And now follows a very important step that you may not forget. When we would save this file, it would be saved as a series of characters, character names with information about font and the font size. Well, that is information that DeskProto cannot handle. DeskProto needs a drawing, the lines that define its character in a drawing. Well, Inkscape can convert this design to such drawing, and that is option in path and then object to path. So now it has converted this to a vector drawing, and I can finish Inkscape by exporting this in an SVG file. Okay, I want to have an SVG, scalable vector graphics, to import, to export it as a vector drawing, and I want to place it, let me simply for this project place it on the desktop and call it William.svg, save the file, and in fact that's all. I can quit Inkscape now and go to DeskProto. Start DeskProto. There it is, version 8. We need version 8 to do V carving, as the previous version didn't yet support it. I need now to use one of the paid editions. The free edition does not support V carving. So I'll use one of the paid editions, and for this project I want to use the wizard, as is a very simple project. Well, you need to check if the machine that is selected is indeed your machine. For me this one is okay, and I want to use basic vector machining. The first step, as always, is to load CAD data. We saved our SVG file on the desktop. Here it is, William. And here we are. This is the text that we want to machine. Skill factor, let me check the dimensions. Well, this is fine for the sign that I want to create, so scaling is not needed. Rotation is not needed as well. And I also do not want to use a fixed machining depth. That would be needed if the V groove would be too deep, and we would want to limit it by a horizontal surface. Well, this is a simple sign. I do not want to use that option. Next, the dimensions of the block. My block is larger than this bounding box of the CAD data, and my block is 250 times 80 and 20 millimeter. Oh, that is too quick. 20 millimeter thick, here we are. The workpiece 0 point, that this will not be visible in all DeskProto editions, for instance not in the entry edition, but I will leave it as it is. This blue cube sets shows the position of the workpiece 0 point on the corner left front top corner of the block. And later on the machine, we need to make sure to set the machine 0 point on that same position of the block. Next, here we, this is the most important page. Here we want to select V carving as toolpath type, but obviously it cannot yet be selected, and that makes sense, as V carving is possible only when you use a V bit. So I will use a conical cutter, 45 degrees. And now I can select V carving, and I want to use the material button as depth, though in fact an unlimited depth, because the depth for this design will not become close to this minus 20 millimeters. Feed rate and spindle speed, well, they will depend on the machine that we are using, so I can't give general guidelines for your machine, but normally speaking the defaults are okay for the machine. I will leave them as they are for our machine. Step over only is needed when you have a groove with a flat bottom. We don't have that. Support tabs are not needed. Roughing, I will select use maximum for this cutter, as my groove will not be very deep, about 2.5 millimeters, and my cutter can do that in one go. So I can calculate toolpath. Here we are, and we seed one toolpath through the center of each character, creating the groove that we need. It will be very quick in 2 minutes. Next, I have already shown the toolpath. I can now also show a simulation. This is what it will look like. So this is indeed what we want to machine. And the final step is to write the NC program file. I'll again put it on the desktop and call it William. That was not correct. William, here we are. Save, and we have indeed saved William.iso. The file extension will depend on which machine you have selected, so this file should be okay for your machine, and we can finish the wizard. And as a last step, I switch off the simulation. I can show a toolpath animation, show the true cutter, and this is the movement that the tool will make on your machine, and miraculously the V-carving will make sure that your design of the name William will be present in this sign, as you will see when we go to the machine. And here is the result, a nice nameplate, a nice sign. This is a piece of oak wood, ancient oak wood, at least 100 years old. And well, it has a very detailed result, as you can see, and that for a machining time of roughly 2 minutes. So that's a great result for so short a machining time. Okay, much more can be said about a V carving. For instance, you can do it the other way around. Leave the characters up, standing up, and you can use V-carving to create beautiful inlays. So more tutorial videos will follow. I hope you now have enjoyed the lesson about how to make a V-carving sign. Thank you.